Hello everyone, and welcome to the 16th episode of Nina in Knitting. My name is Nina, and I live in central Finland with my husband, our two kids, and a dog. I'm not on Instagram, but you can find me on Ravelry as Ninima, and you can also find the podcast group, Nina in Knitting podcast group, by searching in the groups tab or clicking on the description box or the link in the description box. That'll lead you to this episode's thread in the group, and you can find the group like that. I have an introduction thread, an Ask Me Anything thread, and the episode threads in there. Plus, for the time being, we have a knit along thread there too. Today is Friday, March the 31st. So officially, this is the last day of my knit along called Stripes, Stripes Everywhere. It's been over 3 weeks since I last recorded. I had intended to record about a week ago, but then I had a seminar on the Friday, and then I was working in a dog show all weekend, so there was no time for recording anything. So it's been over 3 weeks. You can't tell by the number of FOs, unfortunately, but maybe that will be compensated in the number of, or the amount of, stash enhancement, maybe. Anyway, so the episode title is It's All About the Stash. Yeah, I do have a couple of projects. I'm going to show you a couple of FOs and some WIPs, but the bigger part is the stash. It's not all new stash. Like I told you last time, I just couldn't fit everything that I had bought by last episode in the backpack I had. For today, I have a plastic bag with me, so I have all the yarn I have acquired since way before last episode, right until now. So what else? After last episode, one day I was at work, walking from one building to another, and I happened to see a young lady. She was walking towards me, and as she was getting closer, I think she was maybe smiling a little or something, and when we got to speaking distance, she asked me if I was Nina, and then she mentioned that she has seen my podcast. So that was really fun. That was the first time anybody who has really watched my podcast has somehow speaking to me in real life. Actually, one of my students mentioned that they had found my podcast, but I doubt they watched it because they're not the knitting type, I think. Anyway, so that was the first one, and it really brightened up my day. So whoever you are, passerby, thank you. It was a very nice encounter, and since it was somewhere in the morning, like 10 a.m. or something, so it really was a nice start to the day. I had one lecture, and I was going to go to another one. And then maybe a few days after that, I was taking my daughter to daycare. We were walking from our building towards the daycare center, and Helike, you happened to pass by, and she introduced herself, and we chatted a bit, and that was really nice to meet her in person. She had already told me online that she lives somewhere nearby, But now I got to see her and know that this is Helike. So, hi, it was nice meeting you. Yeah. Okay, let's talk about the cowl, the stripes everywhere cowl a little. So today, March 31st, is the last day of the cowl. I'm gonna lock the thread tomorrow morning local time somewhere when I get to do that, when I get a chance to do that. There are over 40 finished objects, so that's kind of nice. Mine will not be finished. My main stripes everywhere project will not be finished by midnight. I'm going to show it to you later, but yeah, it's still in progress, but that's fine. I could have extended the deadline or, you know, moved the deadline, but nah, it's all right. I'll be drawing the prizes. So we have three prizes, the project bag, the stripey project bag, donated by Helikeju is one of the prizes. Then the second one is the self-striping yarn from Ostrom & Step. And then there is the third prize, which is also a self-striping yarn. It's from an Etsy store from Nicole C. Mendez. I've shown them to you before, and I'll make a separate small video from the prize drawing, and I'm going to show you the prizes there also. So that'll be uploaded possibly this weekend anyway, I'm sure. Pretty sure this weekend. Anyway, I will be drawing the prizes tomorrow, but I can't be 100% sure that I will be uploading the video tomorrow, because life happens, as you know. Right, let's get to the finished object. First of all, I've got to say that I'm in the forest again. The sky is pretty cloudy. I can't see the screen at all, really, and it seems very, very dark from where I'm standing at the moment, and I'm really hoping it's better when it's uploaded or moved to the computer. If not, I'm sorry, there's just nothing I can do, and I'm not gonna do this again tomorrow or any other day, so this is it, good or worse. Oh, my feet are getting tired. So my finished objects, I have two. The first one is something I was working on last time, and you can see these lovely stitch markers. This is the sock I was working on. So this is the pattern called Twisted Madness. It's for the Sock Madness 11 event or competition that I'm taking part in, and I had, oh, I forgot the blocker. I had, this is the cuff down pattern, and I had started from the cuff. I was past the heel, and I was working on the leg last time I was recording. If I can get it over the heel. Yeah, so I was about here. And these stitch markers are here because there were certain requirements for the sock, a certain amount of repeats in each section. So these mark all the sections, and as you can see, the shape of the sock is pretty weird. That is because it will not fit anybody's foot, I'm sure. The length of the foot is, I think I could fit it to my husband. So he has a 40 European size 46, I think, foot. So this is this long, and I could, you know, stretch it even further. But I'm sure that this part will not fit over his heel. So until right about here, this was going to be a really nice sock for myself. I tried it on, it was really nice. I think the heel was really good. And you know, it was pretty nice. And I kind of like the patterning, how the stitch patterning looks like. Although it was very painful to knit. This yarn is Drops Delight. And Drops Delight is, I guess it's not actually a sock yarn. It was just something I had in my stash. And so I just decided to use it. It's very, very splitty. And it was painful to knit this. And as you can see, I ran out of yarn. So when I had gone somewhere here and I could see that I would run out of yarn, I stopped and took another set of DPNs, 3.0 millimeter, which is the one that I use for the fingering weight yarn socks, and 3.0 millimeter is US size 2.5. So I had another set of DPNs of the same size and I knit the second sock to the toe decreases and just, you know, wanted to see how far I could go with the yarn, because I had two balls, two 50 gram balls, and the first ball lasted until here and then the second one was so I have just a little bit of Drops Fable Rust colorway just here on the tip of the toes, and that's, oh, it's fine color wise but the sock itself is just crazy shape. I'm not sure what I'm going to do with them. Ripping or tinking back this yarn, I'm not even sure if it can be made or can be done, but it will be painful anyway. So I'm not sure. I may try and ask if there was a youngster in amongst my say Facebook friends who have this part of the foot narrow enough so that they could fit these socks and have a size 46 foot. I don't know, but they're done. These were for the qualifying round for the Sock Madness, and since I finished them in time, I was put in a team, and there are 42 people in our team originally after the qualifying round, and then maybe 2 weeks ago, the second pattern for the Sock Madness was released. So this is the first actual competition round or something, and only 35 contestants from each team would go further from this round. And this is the second sock for the Sock Madness, and I'm gonna put it in the locker because I didn't do it already. Anyway, so this pattern is called Dropping Madness. It's by Maria Eggblad, and it's a stripy sock, so it kind of goes nicely with my cowl, even though of course I'm not, you know, eligible for prizes, but you know, I showed these socks in the cowl thread. Anyway, so whereas those were cuff down, this was a toe up sock. Whenever I do a toe up sock, I've only knit a few pairs, But I always start with DPNs because they are at the needles I am used to. And so I, for these socks, I only did the first round, which is the trickiest round, the most fiddly round from when you're knitting toe up. But it's, you know, when it's something that you already know and you feel comfortable with. So that's why I did it with the DPNs, and then I changed into circular needle 3.0 again, 3.0 millimeter, which is the 2.5 US 2.5, and I switched to that and finished the sock with the circular needle. So there are two socks in here, and this crazy, wonderful variegated yarn is a Cosmic Strings sock base in colorway Warrior, and I'm just in love with this color, and I'm really happy. There are still some, I don't know, maybe 60 grams left, so I might get another pair for just this variegated yarn. And then this brown, this rust color is the one I used for the first pair, so in the tip of the toe. So this is Drops Fable in colorway 110, which is rust. And then there is this sort of slip stitch, twisted, whatever, patterning, and then an afterthought heel. And that's something I had never done before, and they turned out pretty nice. I'm pretty happy with it, and I don't think it was difficult at all, just different. So I'm really happy that I knit this pair, because, you know, there's a new thing that I learned, or can I say that I already learned it? Just I've done it before. I've done the afterthought heel once, so I'm pretty happy with it. What I'm not happy about is the bind off, and this is the problem I've had with my other toe up socks too. I hate the flare, and I'm pretty sure it is me, and it doesn't show when it's on your foot, but. Like this, when you try to get nice photos, not so nice. So there was it was defined how to bind off. So I did as instructed, but I don't like the outcome in here. But like I said, they're fine when they're on your feet. These socks are just a tad bit too big for me, maybe, and I'm still thinking. My son's foot is now getting bigger than mine. He can't wear my boots or my shoes anymore. Not that he wanted to use many of my shoes, but some. And I might give these to him if he would like them, or then I'll just put the pair in my closet and see if I wanna, you know, keep them to be a present to somebody. That remains to be determined. But yeah, it was a fun project to knit. And I just barely made it to the next round. There were still two spots left for the next round after me. So it's cutting it really close. But I did. So it'll be fun. The next pattern will be released, I think, early next week. Because we don't know for sure. But this round will end next Monday, I think. Nothing more to say about that. Oh yeah, the fiber content on both of the yarns was 25% nylon and 75% merino, so your basic sock yarn. And I really, really liked the cosmic strings colorway, and it was sort of shiny. The fabric didn't shiny at all, but the cosmic strings was a little shiny, so very, very nice. Okay, works in progress. The notorious breathing space. All right. So, last time I recorded, I told you that I had done the shoulder part for the breathing space pattern by Vera Välimäki, and that I was doing the sleeves first and then the body. And this is the first sleeve I knit. You can see the stitch or the progress keeper stitch markers wherever I have made a decrease. And this is where I was last time I showed you this. So I knit the sleeve. Oh no, that's not the sleeve. This is the sleeve because it has something extra. So this is the first sleeve. And I was here when I showed it to you. I'm really not sure what you can see on the screen. I wanted full length sleeves, so I did. I did try it on a couple of times, but it's kind of hard when you're using DPNs, as I was for the sleeves, 4.0 DPNs, which are US size 6. And after I had finished the sleeve, first of all, the ribbing, twisted ribbing, I changed into 3.5 millimeter, and I don't know what that is in US sizes, but I found it was kind of loose for the ribbing. So what I decided is that I'd make more decreases along the sleeve, and then I'd maybe decrease a couple more before I started the ribbing, and then I'd use even smaller size needles for the ribbing. So I did for the second sleeve. So this is where the sleeve started, and I made more decreases. I used a 3.0 millimeter, oops, DPNs for the rib, and I decreased 4 stitches before I started ribbing, and I think this is a way better. This is way better. So this is how I'm going to redo the rest of this sleeve, and that is why I have the DPNs here, because these are the 3.0 DPNs, and I'm going to use the size 4 for the actual sleeve, but in order to rip it back as easily as possible, I just picked up the stitches from the row from the previous row before the next decrease. And they're already on my DPNs here. I'm gonna just rip it back, undo the bind off, and then I'm just gonna continue with the 4.0 DPNs doing the decreases and then change into these 3.0 millimeter, I guess they're bamboo DPNs for the ribbing and the bind off. And after I have done that, I could probably do it today, or this evening. Then I still have all the body to do. And from what I've heard or read online, people have had to make quite a bit of adjustments to the body part, but we'll see. Maybe. When I next when I do my next episode, maybe I'll have this finished, maybe I won't. That remains to be seen. But yeah, this is the status of my cow project. It's not gonna be ready, wah, wah, but you know, it's fine, it's gonna be gorgeous anyway. I forgot to mention the yarn, the red one is Stranded Dye Works Paradise MCN base, so 80% merino, 10% cashmere, and 10% nylon. And the white color, the pretty white looking color, is Drops Baby Merino, which is 100% merino yarn. That's my work in progress, the one that I've been working on right now. But then there is another one that I was doing for a friend, and just kind of paused. I'm gonna show it to you and then I'm gonna explain why. This is in my Anita yarn project bag, sock project bag, which is cute and small, and it's perfect for this size project. This is a pattern called Heartbreaker by Rea Järvenpää, and so it's a baby boot, a baby sock, I guess boot. A bit like this, I think. The yarn I'm using is not the one recommended in the pattern. The pattern uses Novita Nalle, which is the DK yarn. And this is Novita. I have the ball here. Novita Ajaton, like this. I haven't seen this before. I just bought it, I don't know, a month ago? No, maybe 2 months ago. A while ago, a short while ago. And this is 100% acrylic, I think. Yeah. Very, very soft. So I think it's gonna be very nice for baby boots. But not like... is 75-25 yarn, so 75% wool, 25% nylon sock yarn, pretty sturdy one, and this is very soft, so it's like floppy like this. So I guess that's one of the reasons why I'm kind of a little undecided, but maybe I'll just, you know, finish the boot. And they're pretty big. The baby that these were intended for was already born at the beginning of this month, I think. And, well, these are way, way too big for her. Maybe 6 months old or 1 year. I don't remember anymore. My baby's not is 4 years now. A willful 4-year-old. But yeah, I think they'll be cute once I get them finished. But just, you know, this yarn is just so different from Nalle, and I was kind of thinking, should I just rip it back and get some Nalle yarn? I don't know. But maybe I'll just finish them. They'll be fine and cute and very, very soft. So Heartbreaker is a paid for pattern on Ravelry. And I used 3.5 millimeter DPNs for these. So that's a US size 4. I've marked it down in here. Yeah. Very nice for a girl. Yay. Okay. So that's my other work in progress. Now I'm going to pause to get rearranged. All right. For the stash enhancement, which is kind of a lot, but like I said, it's not all something I have bought since last episode, and actually not all that I have bought, period. First of all, I'm just gonna go over them in sort of chronologic order. So the ones that I had already bought last time, but I just couldn't fit in my backpack. First of all, there are two skeins of Novita Venla yarn. This is a fingering weights yarn. So Novita is a very basic Finnish yarn company. And I didn't even know they had fingering weight yarn until, I don't know, sometime this winter. So I was surprised. Okay, so Novita has fingering weight yarn. So this is quite inexpensive compared to a lot of other yarns. So let's say that Östrom Step, which is also the same size yarn ball, is somewhere like 13, maybe 13 euros. This was, I think, 8, 7.90 or something. So it's, well, not half price, but you know, significantly more affordable. And since I'm taking part in both Sock Madness and Tour de Sock this summer, I needed some yarn that was the right weight, but maybe not hugely expensive, because there are things that I'm just learning to do, and I don't want to use very expensive yarn when I'm unsure of what I'm doing. So when I'm learning and it's something that is quite tricky, then I'll just choose a yarn that isn't that expensive. But these are pretty nice, and they're sturdy, you know, basic sock yarn. So it's 75% wool and 25% polyamide. And these are just two self-patterning colorways, their numbers, and I didn't check what they are called by name. Maybe I'll find it online when I'm editing this. Maybe I won't. Anyway, this colorway is number 834, and this one is number 804. So this is like yellow and reds and sort of beige, and then the natural white, off-white, and then this one is more like blues and greens. And if we're doing color work or something, I could combine something, you know, solid colors for these, maybe. I don't know. We'll see what it is. But yeah, these I had already bought. And then there was in a these were bought from a, say, low price store we have here. I'm pretty not I don't know if you can hear the airplane, the sound of the airplane, but what it will do is make this metallic clang on the audio, so I'm really sorry. We have an airport in Jyväskylä. Yeah, it's bad now. So I actually bought a third skein from the same store, something that I hadn't never seen before. And this is also something Finnish. Well, that's not Finnish, to not totally Finnish, and I'm pretty sure this isn't. So yeah, this was made in Turkey, but the company is Finnish. So this is kaupunkilanka. Keskustori is the fingering weight of light line or whatever it is. The sun is coming from behind the cloud. Maybe it will make the colors even worse. I should be facing the sun and not have it behind me. Sorry, I can't move to the other side because it's not, well, I can't. There's stuff in there. Okay, anyway, so I hope this will be okay. So this is fingering weight yarn, 400 meters in 100 grams. And I was talking to the salesperson in the store, and she said they had gotten this yarn last year on July. So it is pretty new brand or new company or something. They had different colorways, and they have sort of the equivalent yarns as Novita. As Novita? So Novita has fingering weight yarn. This is fingering weight, and it's even a tad bit less expensive. So if this was $7.90, this might have been $6.90 or something. And so they have fingering weight yarn, which is this keskustori. Then they have the DK weight, like Novita has, and then they have another one, which is Aran weight, like Novita, Seitsemän veljestä, or Seven Brothers. So I'm looking forward to trying this. This is also $75.25. I think I read it somewhere. Yeah. But if I compare the feel of the two, this feels a little softer. Although I think, sorry, I know that when I talk through the yarn, it muffles the voice a little. Sorry. So I think this skein is a little looser than this one. If you compare the size, I guess this is a little tighter round ball. I don't know. We'll see what they feel like when I knit them. So these were something I had already bought last time, but just didn't show you. Then, as I was doing my show notes for last time, and I had gotten the yarn from Rova Silmosolmo and from her online store. I was doing the show notes, and just to copy paste the URL, the address, I went to her shop, and then I noticed, wow, she has Dosfabu on sale. And I think a very nice color, price for that matter. So I may have ordered a little Dropsfabel, because I do need fingering weight yarn, because I'm going to need fingering weight yarn, and I don't have that much, at least not sort of the rehearsing type yarn. So I actually bought a few different colorways of Dropsfabel, a few equals to six colorways, and each two pieces, so two balls of each color, because you know I'm gonna use them for these competitions. So first of all, this wonderful color, this sort of hot pink, is colorway 109. This petrol color is 105. I think it's petrol. And this plum is 104. And I have two of each, but I just didn't take them with me here in the forest. And the lighter blue is color 103, and this darker blue is 107, and then there is this apple green, which is 112. I know we're doing color work for Sock Madness, and there has been color work in Duotasok, so I will have use of those as well. right? I'm gonna pause for a minute so that I can put all these in a bag and get the third, the crème de la crème, out. Right, so the third sort of encounter, human encounter, from, you know, which has something to do with my podcast, was not a live one. It was online. After my latest episode, I got a PM on Ravelry, and it was from Robin from the States, and she said that she had been watching my podcast. Hi, Robin. And that she would like to send me some yarn. And I was like, say what? She'd like to send me some yarn from the States. And so we messaged back and forth. And of course, as a knitter, you just can't say no to yarn, can you? But I did say that, I know that the shipping costs are pretty ridiculous from the States. But of course, consider if after considering that she would still like to send me yarn, I'd welcome it with open arms, of course. It was just, I was stumped. Anyway, so this Wednesday, I went to the post office to get the package. And first of all, when I opened the package, and I saw the box. It's just, you know, not your regular cardboard box to ship out stuff. The box itself is beautiful. So it's a really nice, sturdy box. Dream big, make today awesome, and you know, this sort of things, you are my sunshine. Really, really nice box. It has a good vibe. And then I opened it. I'm pretty sure you can see it now. As I said, I can't see much from the screen. I always record with my tablet computer, and the glare is, or you know, the reflection is pretty really bad at the moment. Anyway, so it had this really nice paper package stuff, and I'm gonna put it down here so that I can show you the yarn. So inside there was a card from Robin saying that, you know, what sort of yarn she has sent me, and saying that if I want to, I could use these to be as giveaways for future giveaways. I'll talk about that in a minute. Okay, so the first yarn I saw, they're in separate plastic bags. So I'm just gonna open them so that you can see the yarn better. So the first one, there are two of these yarn balls. Is Patton's Croy sock yarn striping. I think this, I guess you can see the picture here. So this is how it's gonna stripe. And we don't get Patton's Croy here. And I've heard people talk about this yarn in different podcasts. I can't wait to try it. So yeah, it's 25% nylon, 75% washable wool. So pretty standard sock weight, sock yarn, and And the colors, you know, they're different shades of blue and then the gray. I mentioned that my husband is kind of traditional when it comes to many things. For example, colors. He's not traditional. I mean, he cooks and does stuff with the kids, so it's not like he's the man of the house and I'm the little housewife. Not, but you know, he doesn't like too colorful clothes. He doesn't like to wear too colorful clothes. So this, if he's good, or if he would like, I might knit him socks from this. Or my son, either one. This is really nice, and it's really great to be able to feel the yarn because I've heard so many people talk about it, the Patton's Croix. And then there is another yarn I've heard people, a lot of people talk about, and it is in another bag. It's the Knit Picks Felici, and there are two balls, but I'm just gonna take out one of them. Just look at this. It is just such cute colorway. There's this sort of minty color, lighter pink, and then sort of almost hot pink, but not quite. And then some lavender or something. Really beautiful. So, Knit Picks Felici is also 75 superwash merino, 25% nylon, fingering weight yarn, and self-striping. So, it'll be really fun to try this and see how the stripes go. And oh, I've seen them on podcasts, but yeah, very, very nice. And very cool to be able to try it. And I think this tea party that there is on the tag, maybe that's the colorway, because I couldn't find a colorway number or name from anywhere else. So maybe it's this tea party. Very nice. Very cute. Very cute. The colors are so cute. I might knit a pair of socks for one of my nieces because I decided that this year I'm going to knit socks for them for the birthday. And the oldest one has a birthday on April, and I already decided that she's getting the pair I knit for the Sock Knitters Anonymous January Mystery Sock. So that's the pattern called Follow the Butterflies. And because they were way too tight for me, and I decided that yes, they would be just right on the dot for my oldest niece. And there are three of them. The youngest one has her birthday on June, so she might get a pair of those socks, and then they will be enough for my own daughter, for example. Then there's more yarn in the box. I have been just there are no words. This came just totally out of the blue, and I can't understand. Okay. So, more yarn, Knit Picks, stroll fingering. This is also something I've heard people talk about. And make believe hand painted. Is that the name of the colorway? Perhaps. Perhaps. Perhaps not. Anyway. So it has these different greens and the purple, and it feels very nice. It's not scratchy at all. I should mention that Novita, and especially the Kaupunkilanka fingering weight yarns, were maybe a little scratchy, so I wouldn't use them for cowls or anything, but this is very, very soft, and I wouldn't mind having it against my face or something. So this is very, very, very soft, not scratchy at all, and it's beautiful. It's also beautiful. I don't know. I have no words. And then there is a fourth one. There's still a fourth one. I mean, really, can't even describe it in Finnish, let alone in English, which is not my first language. Right, so the fourth different yarn there is in the box is Hedgehog Fibers Twisted Sock. So Hedgehog Fibers is something I have seen. I've knit with Hedgehog Fibers sock, the regular sock, and not this twisted one. And yeah, the regular one is kind of splitty, and I've heard people talk about this twisted sock that it's a lot better. It's not at all as splitty. So this colorway is called Magic Potion, and it is 80% blue-faced Leicester and 20% nylon. So I have never used blue-faced Leicester before. I did buy the one skein from Rova Silmo Solmu, or Silmo and Solmu. Didn't buy it, no, I traded it for work. Yes, well, I got another skein of blue-faced Leicester, but I haven't knit with it. And this one, this twisted sock is something I haven't tried at all. And this colorway is really pretty. There are these sort of bright different shades of green, but then you have these pinks and purples and blues, and very pretty, very pretty. So I'm sorry to disappoint you, my dear viewers. None of these will be giveaways. I'm keeping them all for myself. I will, of course, you know, get you giveaways. But since I don't know if I can get knit picks anywhere from here, I've never seen it in any yarn store I've been to. Haven't been to too many in Finland, but anyway, I don't think you can get knit picks from here. Nor have I seen Patton's Croy anywhere. So I just, you know, I want to keep them for myself and use them myself. As for the Hedgehog Fibers too. But I will have other giveaways, and I will get yarn from places which will be more accessible for me than these. Yeah, I mean, like I've thanked Robin via PM several times, I think, and I've told her that I'm just, you know, speechless. This was a total surprise. I don't have any sort of anniversaries or anything, but you know, so it's wonderful. And it just goes to show that knitters really are the best. You know, we guys are the best. Yeah. I'm just gonna pause for a while and then I'll wrap it up.
Sorry, I just forgot. I was maybe high on yarn fumes or something, but I forgot to mention that Robin also included some chocolates in her package, and my daughter found them, and she was, "Oh, I want some chocolate." And I was like, "No, you're not having them yet." So, yes, they were very, very much appreciated, and today we will have them, but you know, a sweet little extra, if as if the yarn hadn't been enough. So it's just amazing. Okay, I'm just gonna record this last stuff holding the tablet in my hands. It'll be shaky maybe a little, but you know, the sun is really coming from behind the clouds, so I guess this way it'll be better. Anyway, so what comes next? So tomorrow I will close the cowl thread and draw for the winners of my three prizes for the cowl, and I'll be posting them in a separate small video clip. And next week at work we'll have an exchange teacher from Belgium, so that'll be interesting. He'll be teaching a few of my classes, and it'll be really interesting to hear about their life in Belgium, studying, and you know, the everyday life the Belgians have, because those are the topics that he's going to talk about. Then next weekend, so not this one, but a week from now, we'll have a sort of crafts and yarn or crafts fair maybe here in Jyväskylä, and there'll be a few vendors, yarn vendors, and different people who make handmade things and sell them. So I'll be going there. I was there last year. I didn't buy that much then. Don't have. Okay, well, I'm just not gonna say anything about that. I might buy something from there, but I'm definitely going anyway, because it is here in Jyväskylä. And then of course Sock Madness 11 is still going on, and I'm still in, but for the next round I think they're eliminating five from each team, and well, we'll see how it goes and we'll see what happens. Anyway, it's an interesting experience, and that's something that I'll be talking about next time I podcast. So I think, well, 2 weeks from now I'll be going to my mom's, because that's Easter and we're having a family get together in there, and I don't record stuff at my mom's. I don't think I will, but you know, we'll see what happens. We don't have lessons on the week before Easter, so I will have things to do. I have some exams I have to grade and get stuff ready for the courses and so forth, but you know, I don't have, or I can, you know, plan my own schedule that week. So maybe I'll be able to record something before we go to my mom's on that weekend, because my kids are at school and daycare during that week also. So maybe I'll have time to record. But I'm not making any promises there to either, because like I said, last time I thought I would record in a couple of weeks, and well, it ended up to be 3.5, so you know, we'll see. In the meanwhile, I hope you're having a great time. I think that in many parts of, for example, Europe, the spring is really on. I'm just gonna take some footage from the surroundings here, and as you can see at the moment, you know, we have snow. We still have snow, a lot of snow here in the forest, not as much in the streets. A lot of ice though. So in many places the roads can be slippery, especially the pedestrian roads. So it's not always that fun to be walking around or, you know, riding a bike as I do to work and back. But yeah, if the spring is already on wherever you are, I hope you're enjoying seeing how the different plants and everything come to life. And if you're like me and we're still waiting for spring to arrive, like full on, well, this is a fun time in a way also. So I hope you're having a good time. I hope you get a lot of knitting time if that's what you want to do. And well, in any way, I hope you're well, and I'll see you in maybe 2 weeks. Take care. Bye.